guys. So, after attaining one in the last video, I came to realise no one remembers Skylanders anymore. So, I thought I'd do my part. I'm going to hang these flyers around reminding everyone about their Skylanders.
Skylanders Giants was the second game in the Skylanders series and released right as the toys in the games craze was really beginning to take off. The first game in the series was titled Spyro's Adventure. Yes, that's Spyro. He was barely used in the game series and was mostly just used to sell the first game. After that, Skylanders was well known enough that they didn't need Spyro anymore. He still appeared in the later games but wasn't really that important. As a lad, I started on Giants but later got Spyro's Adventure for the DS and later PC.
Are you starting to see a pattern here?
I remember the day the game arrived, me and my siblings fought it out to see who would get what Skylanders. Because of me being the oldest out of all of them, I got the first pick and decided to get this guy. The game starts in a toy store where the main villain Chaos was banished to in the last game. He talks to your toys before his pal Yoda returns into the game. I really like this scene as a lad as it really sold the idea of bringing the toys into the game.
Greetings!
Suddenly this guy appears and talks to you about the story of the game. The giants were ancient Skylanders who were banished to Earth by robots called the Archaeans. They've only just appeared on Earth and you need to send them back as Chaos awakens the Archaeans and you need to fight and stop them. We are then introduced to our friend throughout the game, Captain Flynn, in my opinion the best character in the Skylanders expanded universe. You use his ship as a hub world to travel to various levels in the game. I always liked how the first few levels were us just doing missions to help get Flynn's ship working. We get him an engine, a music player, everything.
Awesome! Now it's finally a road trip!
Gameplay of the Skylanders series is rather simple, and mostly in the style of a beat-em-up. The first two games didn't allow you to jump, which I always found odd. It was later added in later games, but the first two, you'd always have to use bounce pads to jump around. Each character would have a couple of attacks, and you could upgrade them throughout the game. Each level features a lot of secrets and collectibles, as well as mini-games to play. There are also elemental gates that only certain elements of Skylanders can access. This would really encourage the consumer to get as many Skylanders as possible, and it definitely worked on young me. I was like,
where did all my money go?
One cool thing in these games and the later games was the ability to use characters from the older games in this one. Spyro's Adventure characters could work in Giants as well as both of them working in Spot Force, etc. As a lad, I used to get way too excited about what colour base the next Skylanders generation would have for the next game. I remember going to many second-hand shops in my youth and buying the old figures to use in Giants. That was one of the best things about Skylanders, buying a new character and wondering what they'll be like on the way home from the store. This brings me on to the point where Skylanders isn't made anymore. Firstly, the characters got way too expensive for anyone to buy them at all. I'd come off the series by this point, but for the last game, Skylanders Imaginators, my brother could only manage to buy like 4 characters because of their high prices. Another reason was oversaturation. A new one of these games came out each year along with Disney Infinity and LEGO Dimensions. Giants was right to come out a year later after Spyro's Adventure, as it capitalised on the first game's success. But then, they should have taken at least a year off before making the next game, because people were happy with Giants, they didn't need another one yet. Rushing out the games was very apparent in the later games. The last two felt very lazy and bland compared to what we got with the first two. For some reason in Swap Force they changed the art style and later again in Superchargers. They both didn't fit with the sort of ancient and mystical style of the original games. Each new game tried to add in technology and cars which just didn't fit in that universe either. For those wondering, here is my thoughts on each game. Even though the Skylanders series became bland and repetitive, Giants is still a great game and still very enjoyable to this day. It released at just the right time and was a great sequel to the first game, although the gameplay is mostly the same between the two. Skylanders Giants truly was a great game.
So, hopefully that video will be beneficial in reminding people about Skylanders, but what I think is going to be more beneficial is these flyers. Oh shoot, it's going to rain soon.